A city that revolutionized information technology in India. A city that inspired The World is Flat, a bestseller on globalization. A city that has evolved from Garden City to Silicon Valley of the country. Let's take a view of Asia's fastest growing and India's most livable city, Bengaluru. Bengaluru has connectivity through all major modes of transport, be it air, rail or road.
If you arrive in Bangalore via flight, then you will arrive here at the Kempegowda International Airport. This is located about 40 kilometers north of the city.
To get to the city, you can either take the local buses or the local taxis. The Bangalore City Railway Station is located at the heart of the city in Majestic. It serves as the main railway station for the city. Opposite to the city railway station stands the Kempegowda bus stand, commonly called the Majestic bus stand. This serves as the nerve center for buses coming in and going out of Bangalore.
Commuting in Bengaluru is not very simple given the hugely congested roads.
You have local buses, taxis and autos as the best means of city transport. When taking an auto, make sure that the meter is being used. If they ask extra money, be firm and refuse to board. Popular taxi services in Bangalore are Uber and Ola cabs, which ply frequently as pickup and drops to different parts of Bangalore. Some of the areas are also connected via metro.
Kick back your heels and relax in Bangalore with fun activities to explore at leisure.
Bengaluru is known to be the Garden City due to its large green patches. Amongst the largest and oldest ones, which act as the lungs of the city, are Lal Bagh Botanical Gardens and Cubbon Park. If you're looking for a combination of history and nature in one stop, Lal Bagh is where you should head. Lal Bagh is home to a rock formation that has attracted attention from geologists across the globe. The layers of rock here were discovered to be one of the oldest on planet Earth. It is also where India's largest collection of tropical plants brought in from different parts of the world are taken care of.
This is also the spot where the famous annual flower shows are held on January 26th and 15th of August. Be sure to mark it in your calendar.
Cubbon Park, nearly 300 acres of green. One could spend an entire day at Cubbon Park. Its tall trees, colonial architecture, and walking trails are forever inviting.
If you're an early riser, you should come here for a quick jog or leisurely walks in its beautiful environment. You can stroll about in the cool evening as well. The entry is free for all.
If you can, you must catch a music or dance performance at Bandstand on every Sunday. Explore a forest and observe endangered animals in their natural habitat at Bannerghatta National Park. There are three kinds of safaris for you nature lovers. The lion and tiger safari, the deer safari and the bear safari. The best time to visit is between September and January.
As I'm at Wonderla Amusement Park with rides guaranteed to thrill your entire family.
Wonderla, if you want an adrenaline rush from some crazy and want the thrill of some amazing water rides, Wonderla is definitely the place for you. The amusement park is an exciting attraction and has innovative rides like the Wagon, Maverick and also a slice of the beach at a wave pool. One can spend a whole day here and remain wanting for more. Jayaprakash Narayan Biodiversity Park is one of the biggest parks in North Bengaluru. This sprawling green space has over 20,000 varieties of exotic plants and over 250 varieties of trees and shrubs. The rock garden is a beautiful spot.
definitely try the acupressure walk park here walking barefoot. I find it soothes my aching feet. It feels wonderful.
The park has a jogging track and four lakes that are great spots for picnics. Located in the middle of residential areas of Malleshwaram and Sadashivnagar is Sankey Tank. This water body was created 135 years ago in 1882 and still stands as an oasis for the urbanized area. The tile track is a paradise for walkers and joggers. Madiwala Lake, maintained by the Forest Department, is home to several rare migratory birds and is also a fun boating destination. The Nagwara Lake in Hebbal is a great place to enjoy boating. And the Lumbini Gardens here offers water amusements and other exciting rides for kids. Alsur, Yeriyur, Agara, Kaikondanahalli, Puttanahalli, Jakur and Hebbal lakes are some of the other water bodies in town. In the vicinity of Cubbon Park lies the Vishweshwaraya Industrial and Technological Museum. Here you can explore fascinating aspects of science displayed in a very creative, fun and engaging manner. With live demonstrations, learning by doing and fun-filled experiments, this museum takes your knowledge of science to a whole new level. Another delightful museum you should visit, especially if you're an aviation enthusiast, is the Aerospace Museum at HAL. It is the first of its kind in India.
Don't forget to try the exciting aircraft simulators. They give you the real feel of flying fighter jets and commercial aircrafts.
It's fun and you get a real good understanding of how flying works.
Shop till you drop at the amazing options Bengaluru has to offer. From flea markets to uptown luxury malls, Bangalore is an amazing shopping destination to suit all pockets. Let's take a tour around Bangalore's swanky malls, delightful little street shops and markets. To all those who think shopping is the best medicine, let's explore the right spots in the city to get your fix of retail therapy.
Welcome to Bangalore's shopping district. Commercial Street, the name says it all.
Commercial Street has many lanes and alleys to go exploring in. Here you will find stores of various products, from clothing to toys to home decor. Here, bargaining is the key to happiness. The popular Mahatma Gandhi Road is one of the busiest and well-known roads in the city, with restaurants, shops, cafes and office spaces. Visit Lido Mall, the Holy Trinity Church and the Kaveri Handicrafts Emporium in its vicinity. Stroll in the walkway beside the Bangalore Metro Station at MG Road. Perpendicular to MG Road stands the Brigade Road, which is also among the most visited shopping areas in Bangalore. Stores with both local and international brands can be found here. The place is always buzzing with many amazing restaurants and clubs to spend time in. Visit Phoenix Market City, the largest mall in Bangalore. Located close to KR Puram on Whitefield Road, it's a happening mall full of exciting things to discover. The sheer variety of brands and showrooms here are amazing. Phoenix Market City has hosted some of the most famous musicians and singers in concerts. Their weekend concerts and live gigs are not to be missed in this beautiful courtyard.
Welcome to Bangalore's busiest and oldest marketplace called Chickpet.
Chickpet is a popular hub for shopping at reasonable prices. From antiques to gold jewellery, from art supplies to clothes, there is almost not a thing you can't find here. The market is ancient and the streets are narrow. Indira Nagar, Indranagar in the east of Bangalore is dotted with most fashionable shops, cafes and bistros. This is one area which calls for a leisurely shopping experience. The 100 feet road here is a swanky street and gives endless retail options.
Mantri Square, a key lifestyle shopping destination, is located in the heart of Bengaluru, Malleshwaram.
The world-class infrastructure here has a hypermarket with over 250 retail outlets and over 10,000 national and international shopping brands. The mall is a shopper's heaven.
Mantri Square is well connected by metro, so getting here is not a hassle.
They say every Indian woman looks her best only in a sari.
I'm here at Messe Sari Udyog, known to be one of the best places in Bangalore for Indian ethnic wear. I can't wait to buy a masterpiece for myself. Luckily, the sales advisors here are extremely knowledgeable and they make the selection process extremely easy. I found my sari. If you intend to shop for exquisite products and at the same time earn good karma, you must visit the Ant store.
Located in Indranagar, the Ant store is one place that sells items sourced from NGOs across the Northeast India.
The purchase of baskets, pottery, jewelries and clothes available here result in the direct contribution to the uplifting of the weavers and tribals. So you can shop to your heart's content without feeling too guilty.
Bangalore has a rich and interesting history of over 1,000 years with a fascinating heritage and diverse culture. Let's explore some of the landmarks which stand tall and symbolizes Bangalore's culture and past glory. The grand structure here is Vidhana Sauda, in the heart of the city. The seat of state legislature in Karnataka is an iconic and historic landmark of Bangalore. Be a part of royalty at Bangalore Palace. It's a unique palace with a Tudor and Gothic style of architecture, decorated with elegant wood carvings, floral motifs, and original paintings by Raja Ravi Verma. There are about 35 luxurious rooms with stained glass and mirrors, especially imported from England.
ISKCON Temple, and this is one of the most popular and the largest destination for both devotees and tourists.
The Sri Radha Krishna Temple is a huge cultural complex established to promote Vedic culture and spiritual learning. There are both morning and evening darshans to accommodate the large turnout of people who visit the temple.
Today we're here at the Art of Living Center, a perfect place to relax and rejuvenate.
It is the international headquarters of the humanitarian movement founded by Sri Sri Ravi Shankar, operating across 152 countries in the world.
The Art of Living is popular for its breathing technique called the Sudarshan Kriya, meditation, yoga and personality development programs that attract thousands of visitors every year. Located around 17 kilometers from the Banshankri bus stop on the Kanakpura main road, the Art of Living Center, also commonly known as Sri Sri Ravi Shankar Ashram, is well connected by city buses.
Head to Chitrakala Parishad for one of their amazing handicrafts expo, or look at some lovely paintings inside their art gallery. It houses 13 museums with collections ranging from traditional Mysore paintings, leather puppets, sculptures to paintings by the famous Russian artists Nicholas and Svetoslav Rorik.
We're here at the historic Bull Temple of Baswanguri today, and the Nandi idol carved here is a monolith and one of the largest in the world. Built in the Dravidian style of architecture, the temple is dedicated to Nandi, Lord Shiva's vehicle, which is the main attraction here. This is one of the oldest temples in Bangalore. Legend goes that the temple here was built to pacify a bull that used to destroy the groundnuts grown by the farmers.
After the temple was built, the bull miraculously stopped eating up the crops and left them in peace. In celebration, an annual groundnut fair, the Kadlekai Parse, is held here every year. The Shivratri festival is also a grand affair. On the banks of the Alsur Lake, the Gurudwara Shri Guru Singh Sabha is the biggest Gurudwara in the city. It is a splendid building with a large hall that leads to the Guru's Takht and a palki made of marble.
The devotees and the visitors at the Gurudwara are offered free meals on all the days of the week as part of Langar Seva. The Langar is open to people belonging to all faiths.
This is an archaeological museum with artifacts as old as 5,000 years on display. The museum has a rare collection of old jewelry, sculptures, coins and inscriptions.
The museum is a delight for archaeological lovers. Artifacts and excavations from Mohenjo-daro, Halebidu and Vijayanagara are found here.
St. Mary's Basilica Church. One of the oldest churches in Bangalore, the St. Mary's Basilica is built in the beautiful Gothic style with arches and stained glass windows. It is located in Shivaji Nagar and hard to miss as it attracts you with its grandeur.
Crimson, the art resource housed in a beautiful heritage villa on Cunningham Road, offers a wide range of modern and contemporary art. In the middle of the buzzing metropolitan and 21st century high-tech Bangalore lie a few sites of grand historic significance.
I stand below the very archways through which Tipu Sultan, the ruler of Mysore, would walk through. This palace, built in 1791, was Tipu's summer residence.
Are you in the mood for food? Then eat like a local.
Bengaluru has one of the most exciting culinary scenes in India. From age-old traditional food outlets to a variety of gourmet restaurants, it truly is paradise for foodies. There are some legendary restaurants, such whose flavors and quality have stood the test of time. If you want to taste the best masala dosas, head to CTR in Malleshwaram or Vidyarthi Bhavan in Gandhi Bazaar. The world's softest, fluffiest idlis, which just simply melt in your mouth, can be found at Veena stores in Malleshwaram. A visit to Bangalore isn't complete without dropping in at MTR, one of Bangalore's oldest and most well-known restaurants. They are the inventors of the Rava Idli, the popular South Indian breakfast. To try a wide range of local treat, from obatto to akki roti and sweets like gulkand and ice cream, Vivipuram is the ultimate street food destination in town.
Many cities of India like Hyderabad, Awadh, Kolkata all have biryanis named after them. What is not so known is that Bangalore too has its own authentic variant of biryani called Bengaluru Donne Biryani. Shivaji Military Hotel is one of the most popular places to try out authentic Donne Biryani. Wondering what Donne means? Donne are the big cups made from eco-friendly palm leaves. Some are made out of papaya leaves too. And this local marvel is served hot and fresh in these leaf cups or donnes. I'm here to enjoy the taste of authentic vegetarian South Indian cuisine at South Indies, Indranagar. A meal at South Indies is nothing short of a journey through South India. This place is a heaven for pickle lovers. You have many tasty pickles to choose from their one-of-a-kind pickle bar.
The restaurant offers a huge buffet spread for lunch and live counters. In a single meal experience, I feel like I have visited and eaten cuisine of all Kerala, Karnataka, Tamil Nadu and Andhra. Vegetarians are sure to have a good time.
Hi, today we are at Chiro, one of the most popular dining destination in the city for Oriental and Asian flavors.
The tranquil zen-like ambience and striking elevated spaces capture the imagination of customers. An organic blend of cuisines, signature cocktails and world-class service with carefully curated music
known to be the pub capital of India. Bengaluru is simply a paradise for the beer lovers, pub crawlers and bar hoppers.
For the best beer in Bangalore, head to Beer Club in Uptown Whitefield.
The first microbrewery in South India, it's a paradise for beer lovers. With some of the finest beer that make regulars to come back for more, the ambience here is just as much as the treat as the brew and the food.
Rock and roll with great music, food and ambience at Hard Rock Cafe, one of the most beautiful pubs in Bangalore with an old world charm that's irresistible. Hard Rock Bengaluru is one of India's largest Hard Rock Cafe, situated in a heritage colonial building.
From the amazing cool weather to the warmth of the locals, Bengaluru has transformed to one of the most progressive metros in the country. Here, every aspect of life in between orthodox to cosmopolitan has a Bangalore's twist. And there is something in store for everyone. To continue watching more videos from TGF, don't forget to subscribe below. Where we're meant to be.